Yo, what's going on, guys? Trayrex is back, and today I'm here with the Stamina Necromancer PvP build. A lot of you guys want to see it, and here it is. I know that we are close to the Stormform patch, but all the sets that I'm using here are possible for the next patch, so it's fine. And yeah, don't forget to like and subscribe, and we start with the build now. And we start the build with the stats, and you can see we have 10k Magicka, 20k health in PvE. In PvP we have a bit more, of course, we have 26k. Maximum stamina we have 29k, I'm using 17 points in health, 47 points into stamina with the lava food soup and sword royce buff food. I'm using the warrior mundus and I'm a Nord. The points here depends on your race, maybe you have to put more points in health, maybe less, that depends on your race. And now I show you the fully buffed stats of the stamina recovery, weapon damage and all those things in serial deal. I show a picture here now. They are completely buffed here with the continuous attack buff too. That means with the, if you take a resource or a keep, whatever, with the extra 10% stamina recovery and weapon damage buff, the stats are completely crazy. You have very good sustain, very good weapon damage. The only problem maybe with the setup are the resistance. I'm a Nord. If you are not a Nord, you can change some things. I'm using the Warrior Mundus here. If you're Orc, for example, you get some extra weapon damage, you can change it to the resistance bonus. Then you get like 3k extra resistance. And you can see I have a high crit resistance. That means I'm wearing a lot of pieces in impen. I show you later if I show the sets that you can change the heavy pieces also to reinforced for some extra resistance. One important information here is that we don't need 30k resistance on the Necro. We have the Ghost. The Ghost gives us also 10% damage reduction. And we have some nice passives. And we have good heal on the Necro. For example, we have the passive that we get 15% less damage from damage over time abilities. And yeah, we have good passives there with the Ghost and everything. 25k resistance are more than enough on the Necro. We don't need 30k here. Now we come to sets that I'm using, and we start with the front bar. And I'm going here with a New Moon Acolyte Maul, Nurnhound, with the spell and weapon damage enchantment. And guys, I know you can write it down 100 times in the comments. I know there's a new moon nerf. It's only 80 weapon damage, guys. It's a nerf. They don't completely destroy the set. Some people going completely crazy. They think the set is completely useless next patch. No, it's just a balance nerf. The set is outperforming everything in the moment, and they have to nerf it a bit. 400 weapon damage is still good. It's still a great set. It's craftable, and the other bonuses are also nice. Penetration, extra weapon damage, crit. It's a good set. And if it's only 400 weapon damage, it's still great. Yeah, it's still a great set. Okay, only for the people that going completely crazy every time if they hear nerf, guys. Nerfs don't mean they destroy the set completely. Sometimes, yeah, but normally a nerf is the balance set. Yeah, and okay, I think you know what I mean here. On the back bar, I'm going with a New Moon Acolyte Mace, or you can go with a sword, whatever. It's a sword and board bar, so it's not important. I'm going with Brutality Training Poisons here. They give me the minor brutality buff, 10% more weapon damage, and train some stamina from the enemy target. Nurnhound weapon for more healings and a bit more damage on the back bar. And the shield that I'm using is the Clever Alchemist shield, guys. I only need a shield here or a weapon because I'm using 4 pieces of Clever Alchemist on the body. Because I have a free slot with the mythic item, I have a free slot and I can use it. The good thing is, if I use 4 pieces on the body, I get the extra weapon damage from Clever Alchemist on the front bar too. And can proc it easy on the back bar. You can see I have 5 of 5 pieces here on the back bar. If I drink a potion, I can easy get the extra weapon damage. And yeah, guys, now I come to the monster set. I'm using Barlog. You can swap it also if you go solo, whatever, to Bloodspawn, whatever. You can go with 2 1 set bonuses. Yeah, with Lord Warden, Mighty Juden, or whatever that gives you resistance. Whatever you want. Then I'm going with the 2 heavy pieces. They are the New Moon chest and the legs. And here I said you can change them also to reinforced if you want some extra resistance. The Barlog shoulder. All the pieces are with maximum stamina here. Clever Alchemist belt. Hands. And shoes. Then the mythic item. I said already that I'm using one. The Torque of Tonal Constancy. It gives me extra stamina recovery if I drop down my Magicka. And it's easy to proc. You can see unbuffed, I already said 1.3k stamina recovery is not that high. And if I buff up with my momentum, my potion, my ghost from the necro passives, and I waste all my Magicka now, it's easy. Yeah, we don't need so much Magicka on the necro. We have 2.7k stamina recovery. It's easy to proc, completely easy. We have a very high uptime. You can see one time the ghost, bam, we are under 50 again. It's super easy, guys, to proc the mythic item. And it's some extra resistance, some extra sustain for us. And yeah, all the pieces here infused with weapon damage. I show all the pieces here again, you can see it. You can change the traits if you want. We have a lot of crit resistance, we don't need that much, you can change it a bit. Depends what you like more. If you want more well-fitted, then go for it. Impen gets nerfed next patch anyway a bit again, I think. There was a small nerf for it again. Then you can change some things. I also want to change some things, but I don't have transmutation stones in the moment. That's the reason. Yeah, I would change the heavy pieces to reinforced and maybe one or two small pieces to well-fitted. Okay, champion points. We start with the tower, like every time. 56 points in Warlord, 1 into Siphoner, 2 into Sprinter, 76 in Mooncalf, 44 in Tenacity, 23 in B4, we have a heal debuff with the Blast Bones, 40 in Tumbling, 28 in Shadow Ward, 27 in Blast, 81 in Master at Arms, 16 in Taumaturge. Some people ask me why I'm using this. It's only if I play the Colossus. If I go solo or whatever, you can go with the Dawnbreaker. But in a group, the Colossus is a nice ultimate and Taumaturge scales with the Colossus. So yeah, that's why I'm using 16 points here. 40 in Precise Strikes, 50 in Piercing and 56 in Mighty. 81 in Ironclad, 40 in Resistant, 56 in Thick Skinned, 37 in Hardy and Elemental Defender and 19 in Quick Recovery. Now we come to the last point of the video, the skills that I'm using, and we start with the Blast Bones here. This skill, you should check it that you use it every time. It's super cheap. Every second cast of it is very cheap. You can see it costs only 1000 stamina. Shoot on an enemy, it's very strong damage here, and it puts a heal debuff on the enemy. So if you use it and it's done, do it directly again before you use the dizzy swing or whatever. Okay, then I'm going with the forward momentum. Yeah, the damage buff, resource buff, and it cleans us from the slows and everything. Necrotic potency gives us some extra damage reduction on the front bar, and of course we can train ultimate points with it and we get a small heal, a very small heal, but it's nice for the ultimate region. Executioner as our finisher, the dizzy swing our spammable. Ultimate, I'm using the Colossus or the Dawnbreaker. If you're solo, go with the Dawnbreaker. The Colossus is also nice, but in some situations they dodge out of it, whatever. It's hard to hit it because the people learn how to dodge, yeah, and they dodge out of it and then you can't hit them. With the Dawnbreaker, you are more safe and you can do some nice combos with the Dawnbreaker, of course. And yeah, but in a group, go with the Colossus. If your friend has a stun with the Dawnbreaker or the fighter get skill, whatever, it's nice, yeah. You buff your full damage, yeah, 30% damage increase. It's definitely strong, yeah. On the back bar, Temporal Guard. The resistance buff, of course. You can also go with the Allomorph. Some people like the Allomorph more. Yeah, both are nice. Yeah, Allomorph makes your Blast Bones a bit cheaper. The Spirit Guardian, yeah, I said already, a heal, and we get 10% damage reduction. The Rigor, our heal over time. Elude, yeah, I like it because we don't have a speed buff with a Necro, and this gives us a speed buff. Yeah, 30% speed buff if we get hit by AoE. If we run around objects, a Zerg is following us, whatever, yeah, it's nice. And the Mortal Coil, insane healing over time, and it gives us some stamina back, and you see it, while slotted, your healing done is increased by 3%. Okay guys, that was the skills that I'm using. I wish you all a nice day. Don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel, write a comment if you have a question to this build, and we see us in the next video. Have a nice day. Bye bye.